يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, every one of us wants to be in paradise. Every one of us wants to be in a good place. Every one of us wants to protect himself or herself from the crisis of the Day of Judgment and the afterlife and the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. So to comfort us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in many places of the Quran, He has told us how we can achieve that goodness. Wouldn't you like to be in the company of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, of the messengers of Allah, the Prophet Jesus, may peace be upon him, Moses, may peace be upon him, Isa, Musa, Harun, alayhimus salam. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon all of them. Wouldn't you like to be in the company of those whom Allah loves, the truthful, the martyrs, etc.? So Allah says, well, if you want that, we can tell you how to achieve. Listen to this. Verse number 69 of Surah An-Nisa. Allah says, very simply put, وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا ذَلِكَ الْفَضْلُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ عَلِيمًا. Amazing. Allah says, whoever follows Allah and His Messenger, that's all you need to do. Subhanallah. Whoever follows Allah and the Messenger, they will be with those whom Allah has bestowed favor upon, from the prophets, from the truthful, from the martyrs, from the pious, and that is the best companionship. It is indeed the favor of Allah. Allah knows best, and He is sufficient and all-knower. Amazing. How simply worded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet it's a lifetime of dedication. Whoever follows Allah and the Messenger, they will definitely be with the right people on the Day of Judgment and in the hereafter. May Allah grant us goodness and comfort on that day of crisis, the Day of Judgment. For indeed, the biggest tests will be passed or failed on the Day of Judgment. May Allah make us from among those who pass those tests with flying colors. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, Allah asks us to ponder over the verses of the Quran in order to achieve comfort. You want comfort? Ponder over the verses of the Quran. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Will you not ponder deeply over the verses of the Quran, the meanings of these verses, and what they have in them? From this, Allah is encouraging us very strongly to actually take the Quran more seriously. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the comfort that we will achieve when we have Allah is such that no matter what news comes to you, you will know how to process the news. How many of us, when we hear something very good, we're quick to tell everyone. When we hear something bad, we're quick to tell everyone, not realizing some people might destroy your goodness because you told them. And some people might celebrate at the loss or the fear you have, and they might cause greater harm against you because you told them. You did not know how to process the news that you got. So if you want comfort, you can avoid the crisis by not telling everyone everything. You need to be slightly secretive about certain things, number one. Number two is, you need to know if you are going to say it to someone, whom you are going to say it to. You need to choose very carefully those who can process, who can give you advice, those who are genuine. If something really grand is going to come in your direction, you're happy about a big business deal, if you were to go and relate that to everyone, they might snatch the business deal away from you. So if they were genuine, they will give you guidance. Similarly, if you have a fear and you were to tell people, if they're not so sincere, they might seize the opportunity to make you even more fearful. So Allah says in verse number 82 and 83 of this particular surah, Surah An-Nisa, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِّنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ ولو ردوه إلى الرسول وإلى أولي الأمر منهم لعلمه الذين يستنبطونه منهم. Verse number 83. Allah says, when they get news of security, safety, the good news, or that of fear, that bad news, they announce it, quick to announce. People forward it, they put it on any social media, the radio, the television, the media, whatever it may be. You don't need to announce everything. Hold on. Allah says, had you processed that information or news in the correct way and related it to those with sound intellect, those who are in authority, in some form of authority, those who are able to extract the gems from that news, then it would have been better. But had it not been for the favor of Allah upon you, you would have followed the devil except just a few. That's what Allah is saying. So yes, there is a context of revelation of this verse, and it's speaking about hypocrites and the way they process news and what they do with it. But the lesson is for every one of us. Remember, when you tell people things, who are you telling and what are you telling them? Are you sure that you want this person to know this particular piece of information? You're sure it's not going to harm you? It's not going to be dangerous in one way or another? Allah says, protect yourselves by knowing who you should be talking to and what you should be saying. We move on to something else. Many of us have an issue sometimes where if we don't like someone, we find it difficult to greet them or to respond to the greeting. Allah says, when you are greeted, reply the greeting. What is a greeting in Islam? It's a prayer. It's actually a prayer where you're asking Allah to have mercy upon someone, or to have peace upon someone, to give them peace and blessings. So you say, Assalamu alaikum, which means may peace be upon you. What a blessed prayer. So Allah says, if they've given you something, give them something in return, which is better than what they gave you, or minimum, give them similar to what they gave you. So when someone says, may peace be upon you, Allah says in verse number 86 of Surah An-Nisa, وَإِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا. When you are greeted with a greeting, greet back with a better greeting. أَوْ رُدُّوهَا. Or, if you don't do that, at least respond to it similarly. Subhanallah. So this is something you need to know. Greet people and respond to their greetings in a beautiful way, and Allah will open your doors. So someone might say, well, I don't really like this person. My brothers and sisters, if there is someone who is harming you day and night, someone whom you know it is proven that they are working towards your downfall, and if you know for a fact that they're greeting you as a mockery, in that case, you don't have to respond to their lies. Why do we say lies? Because they are telling you, may peace be upon you, but in actual fact, they have war upon you. So they're lying. They're being hypocritical. Still, it would be better to just respond to that by just saying, wa alaykum as-salam. But if they're really harming you, there have been instances in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he has not responded to the greetings of some by the instruction of Allah. And he told his companions for a certain time not to respond to the greetings of some by the instruction of Allah. From that we do learn that if there is someone who you know for a fact is making a mockery of it, then you don't respond that particular lies. And like I said, the lies is because they're telling you, peace be upon you, but they don't mean it at all, not at all. They're working in opposite directions. However, Allah says, still try to greet back. Do you know what? Your duty, when someone greets you, just greet them back. Greet them back with a better greeting. Assalamu alaikum, may peace be upon you. Wa alaikum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace of Allah be upon you and His mercy and His blessings, mashallah. So I've greeted you back. Because Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَسِيبًا. Allah counts everything. He's taking account of all of this. He knows. So you will still have the good, you know, on your name. You are still going to have the good in your account. So be good and respond to these beautiful greetings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us genuine. When you're greeting someone, be genuine. How can you say peace be upon you, then you harm someone? How can you say peace be upon you and the mercy of Allah and the blessings, smile at them and then harm them, and then have an ill intention towards them? That's not fair and that's not correct. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't do that. So my brothers and sisters, there is another verse in the same surah, verse number 94, where Allah speaks about those who greet you. Don't jump to say they're not Muslims. Someone says, Assalamu alaikum. And you say, that person's not a Muslim. There is a clear-cut verse in the Quran which tells you, don't do that. Don't just judge a person. They've greeted you. It's okay. That's enough. So Allah says, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ أَلْقَى إِلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامَ لَسْتَ مُؤْمِنًا. O you who believe, when you're walking onto the earth, or when you're traveling, or when you're going out in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then authenticate and verify. Don't ever just say to someone who has greeted you that you're not a believer. So Allah saying, give them the benefit of the doubt. They said, Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikumus salam. Oh, my brother, how are you? My sister, etc. Subhanallah. This is Allah teaching us, clean your heart. Now, usually people say, don't judge others. They are right. I've spoken about how people run away from advice by using the statement, don't judge me. Yet, it's not a judgment, it's just advice. But on the other hand, people say, well, we're judging based on what we can see. I tell you, you judge based on what you can see when you are judging in a dispute between people. If you're installed as a judge in a dispute, in a matter, then you judge based on the evidence that's in front of you. That's what that hadith means. That's what the verse of the Quran means. So the Quran is not telling you that go around judging people and say that, well, I'm just judging by what I could see. Have you given them a chance to explain? Have you given them a chance to show other evidence? So if you're not installed as a judge, you have no right to go out and judge people. Let's remember that. Because in that case, you will create a disaster. Many people are struggling simply because others have uttered bad words or judged them, really have judged them, when they are not installed as judges in an arbitration or in a problem that they're facing. May Allah grant us goodness and save us from the calamity of the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين.